on your reader.
Right? Much better. We will try to complete the tire one so that it will be final. Final visit grammar. Review of SAR. So all the details with respect to vision, mission statements, PEOs, then teaching learning processes, curriculum, POs, CEOs, then how to present that student performance, how to present our faculty qualification, and how to present that facilities and technical support, then continuous improvement, then first year academics, and then governance and all. So all details we will check one more time so that it will be, your knowledge will be concretized. So any doubt is there in the end, I will take, but I hope by now all the doubts are cleared. Tomorrow morning we will have a recap and then a feedback session. I hope by now all the doubts have been cleared. Right? Still today, after covering this SAR, I will take doubts. If at all you have, if you have any questions, you can ask after this SAR. Right? By now you must be clear with, you must be model to other colleges and other faculty for improving the teaching learning process, improving the quality. Right? By now you should be clear about what is vision, what is mission statement. By now you should be clear about what is vision statement, mission statement, how to prepare PEOs, how to prepare CEOs, how to prepare CEO-PEO matrix. By now you should be clear about. Then what kind of innovative methods you can have, what kind of projects you can have, how to display go for the evaluation process, assessment process, how many types of meetings you should have with stakeholders, who are stakeholders, who can be stakeholder, all those things you should have clear understanding. Already I have told you, so our area of expertise and our area of research may be different, but still we should be into all these other activities like admin activities, educational activities, that will indirectly help us improve. Like we have to deal with publications, we have to deal with consultancy work, we have to deal with product development, we have to deal with improvement of teaching learning process. So it talks about our own things only. So obviously, if you are in the process, you will come to know where you are standing at. Right? And already I have mentioned you to take things seriously. Hope all the people are attending the sessions. I have covered the maximum I can do. Still, the last one I have chosen as SAR for Tier 1. So this is similar to all the programs, Diploma, UG, PG and all. So every faculty should be involved in these processes. Earlier it used to be only one teaching or something. So apart from teaching also, we have to be involved in different kinds of activities. Co-curricular, extracurricular, administrative experience, then guidance of various projects, how to write our course outcomes and how to combine these with our program outcomes, and then how many types of evaluation process you can have, how better we can present ourselves. So all these things, and with respect to the teaching learning process, what is pedagogy? So what is pedagogy, you have understood by now? Why MBA accreditation is required? What? Right? So MBA accreditation is National Board of Accreditation. So once you have ACT approval for running the program, to be the best among the people who are doing the same work, so other colleges also may be offering the same programs, you need to be better when compared to them, then there comes the aspect of MBA accreditation. You want to be better among the lot, so you should have MBA accreditation. Suppose there are lapses, somebody is saying PhD is not available, somebody is saying professor is not available. So according to the ACT norms, you try to overcome those. Once you have got ACT approval, you are eligible for MBA accreditation. So norms are as per ACT. I need not comment, and SFR calculation also I have told. So professors required, minimum requirement of professors is as per the ACT norms. If I am not mistaken, sanctions strength is 60 means for a 180 student, that is 3 years, we should have one professor, two associate professors and six assistant professors. So that is, I think, as far as my knowledge is concerned, as per the AICT norms, it is the ratio required. But so you should follow the same AICT norms and all for faculty and faculty ratio, contractual, regular aspect and all, right? Here we are supposed to learn about the accreditation procedure, how to improve our quality of teaching learning process, how we can have improved quality education in our institute and improved institute scenario with respect to other institutes. All those things we have been dealing with. That is what we are worried about in NBA accreditation. So suppose you have already got NBA accreditation and you want more recognition, means you need to enter into NARF. After NARF also we have other accreditation. Philippines, they offer some Malina accreditation, it is called, so they have some other, and then Avit accreditation, American accreditation. So that will make you your institute globally standable, right? American accreditation, so couple of universities in India and other in East Asia, couple of them have gone for Avit accreditation. So remaining means if you assume that you are the best one in the field, so you can go for higher accreditation also. So all these are related to a Washington Accord or like, so those details we are not worried about. So these are different aspects of accreditation, right? So earlier people used to go for ISO accreditation also, if it is required, right? NAC, NBA, ISO, then Avit accreditation, Philippines, or so different kinds of accreditation are possible. So for specific courses like management or some other, so they have their own accreditation bodies, right? Now for management, they have different accreditation bodies. So depending on the program you are in, you can have. And you ensure that it is, you must be clear by now that it is not program, it is not institute, it is only the programs that are accredited, programs. So we need to finalize ourselves whether you are under tier 2 or tier 1 and what kind of programs we have, so UG, PG and all. So today we will, now we will discuss about yeah, so SFR is more than 30 means we should rectify that error and then only we can apply for pre-qual. But pre-qual qualifier doesn't mean, it doesn't involve any money and all, so you can apply and check where you are standing at. Then let the committee decide whether you can proceed further or not. So that's a good idea. You can go for pre-qualifier, even suppose if your SFR is falling below 1:30 for polytechnics. Got it? You can go ahead with the pre-qualifier. Registration and pre-qualifier, then the query will come. In some of the colleges, they do not have proper AACT approval papers year-wise. So then they are stopping then and there. So like this, you can please carry on. Audio and video, I hope it is clear. So we will go ahead. All of you are ready, we will go ahead with the SAR. So all the, irrespective of the program, you please listen to that. So last time we are going through the SARs, tomorrow we will see what are the additional things required. We will see, right? Self-assessment report, so the details are available at nba.in.org under document section, pre-qualifier, tier 1, tier 2 documents, right? For engineering, always a minimum marks, it is about 650, as of now 650 for 2 years accreditation, minimum marks. So that depends on, that may change from time to time, so don't rely on that now. So we have discussed about 1000 marks. Normally with minimum requirement, with minimum facilities, everybody will be able to get 800, assuming that research aspect we do not have, publication aspect we do not have, proper placements we do not have, those even if you negate, we are standing at 850, right? So don't worry about the minimum mark, maybe 650 are like for 2 years, and then 750 are like for 5 years accreditation. Right? So you must be aiming at 850, I'm sure. Even similar course I have done in earlier colleges where they were having so many doubts about whether they could come, whether they could cross 800 or like or 650 they can. So that time also we have identified that around 800 to 850 they can score easily. Still with improvement they can score 900. Right? So again you see, so as a faculty and all, we should be able to define our own vision statement and also the institute. So institute vision mission statements, they will be finalized by the HODs and principal put together and all. So the higher level people, they will finalize, or as a program, or in the sense from the department, we will finalize ourselves and then we will put it to the higher authority. Now officially you should get it approved by the stakeholders. Stakeholders must have been involved in preparing the vision, mission and PEO. So normally they may not be having that much time to discuss with you and all. So then that's why you can prepare your vision, mission statements and then PEOs, get them approved by stakeholders. Right? So all the 10 criteria we have been discussing about. All the 10 criteria we will discuss about again. Now you must be, the audio must be clear. So the first one is institute information. Institute information, name. Thank you. Now name and address of the institute, then name and address of the affiliating university, year of establishment, right? Then type, autonomous or like, then ownership status, central government or state government or like, then any other academic institutions of the trust. And then one more thing I need to tell, this SAR is a guideline again. They have mentioned clearly somewhere that you make it, you can make it flexible, right? So it is only a guideline, right? So you can make it flexible. Details of all the programs being offered by institution under consideration. So what are the other programs we have? So once again I must tell you, there is no minimum, there is no mandatory criteria like, right? All the criteria is as given. So then I must tell you that only programs are accredited, not institute. So there may be a case that even in our institute also, I have told you, we have 4 departments and out of that 1 or 2 are maybe doing, 1 or 2 may be doing good, right? So don't expect that all the 4 programs must be involved in accreditation and they must be eligible for accreditation and all. We should convince our higher authorities. So these are not there, so admission criteria is not proper or faculty strength is not proper, then how we can go for accreditation, right? So we should convince our higher authorities, ensure that minimum requirements are there as per the AICTE norms. So then only we can go for. We are with NITTR Kolkata, so even now, even in our organization also, we cannot say that all the 4 departments are doing good, right? So somewhere there are less number of admissions, somewhere their placement scenario is not there. So in every institute it is like that. Alright, so that's why out of the 1000 marks, so appropriate things you can score. So those things which you are not able to score, that can be negative only. So you try to you try to deduct that, and then finally you can aim at around 850 or 900, or like according to the scenario. Maximum number, minimum number, there is no criteria, right? Criteria wise minimum marks are also not there, right? Criteria wise minimum marks are also not there. So overall it is, overall it should be, right? Then programs to be considered for accreditation in this application. So no minimum, minimum, maximum criteria, even one program also we can go ahead like that. Then total number of employees, minimum, maximum. If it is very much varying, you say minimum, maximum, or you use only one column. If it is not that much variation, we can use only one column. Normally we have only one, either maximum or minimum. Criteria wise minimum marks are not there, please. Criteria wise minimum marks are not there. Criteria wise minimum marks are not there. So till recently I can say 750 out of 1000 is for 5-year accreditation. So that also is being changed, and then 650 or like 650 or above, it is for 2 years. So that pattern may be changing. So they are changing day by day. So according to their regulations, there is no minimum criteria wise marks, right? Let us aim for 800, or let us aim for 900 or like, deducting that research aspect, publication aspect, consultancy project and all, then placement scenario and all. So if you deduct, so you must be arriving at 800 to 850, must. Right? So there is no minimum criteria wise minimum mark is not there, please. So then contractual staff and employees, faculty and staff already, those who are with more than 1 year of experience and drawing consolidated salary, they are eligible for SFR calculation, and you need to put them separately, only regular and contractual, right? And it is as per the norms of AICT. As per AICT norms, this many number should be regular, this many should be contractual. That is their adjective. Suppose in some states there is a problem, and then so as a special case they may consider. So you should go ahead with pre-qualifier. You should go ahead with pre-qualifier, right? I hope audio and video it is clear to you. So if you do not have proper bandwidth, you may not be getting the details, right? I hope all of you are able to listen to me. Important things we are discussing for the last time, right? I hope I have cleared all the doubts till now. So vision statement, mission statement. Now shall I put the question, what is vision? What is your vision? As a person, what is your vision? And what is the vision of your institute? Right? By now you should be clear about vision and mission of the institute, definitely. Don't put too much lengthy statements. I have seen many, so we don't understand what is their vision. Some renowned they will write, and then some say discipline, something they will say, but the meaning is not conveyed properly. So this is the time before going for NBA accreditation, you should sit and finalize. Who have been involved in that program, they must finalize the departmental vision and mission statements, and also institute vision, maybe by HODs and principal put together, they must finalize vision of the institution. Once the vision is fixed, it should not be changed for lifetime or next 20-25 years. We should not change. Only in rare case we will change after 15-20 years, right? Then suppose you want to take the load of NBA coordinator, your name will go to NBA committee, that is Delhi. It will reach Delhi. Your name and your mobile number and all will reach Delhi. So you take the responsibility as NBA coordinator. Normally, suppose institute has five programs. Suppose institute has five different programs, and institute level NBA coordinator will be there. Institute level NBA coordinator will be there, and at that department level or program level NBA coordinators. So this NBA coordinator will be supported by all the faculty. This is NBA coordinator, and then this he will be supported by all the faculty. With a friendly and cooperative environment only we will be able to get NBA. We should not fight with each other, right? NBA coordinator should be helped by faculty. And if we have good number of programs, we have only institute level NBA coordinator. I must tell you, I have been NBA coordinator for this institute and also in the earlier institutes. Institute wise NBA coordinator will be there. So all the coordinates are in consonance with, in collaboration with this central institute wise NBA coordinator, they will approach the principal or management and apply for accreditation, right? So if you more number of programs are there, their fee reduction I think, but don't look for that fee reduction. If you are ready, then only, right? You can go program by program also, no problem. Right, institute level NBA coordinator under that L. Or if the institute is small, only one NBA coordinator is sufficient, right? Faculty should be providing the data, necessary data. So somebody is asking about the role of math, physics, science teachers. Math, physics, science teachers, they will give their course outcome details, their course attainment details and all. For the respective discipline, they will be giving the data. That is the responsibility. They need to prepare their course outcomes, COPO matrix, and then the analysis they should give to the corresponding department. Then, so this is the summary for criteria summary for Tier 1. UG Tier 1, so faculty information, it is the we have maximum marks. So for faculty 200 marks, it is maximum. For CO, POs and all, 200, about 200. Then, so all these four chapters are very, very important. You see, facilities, we have only 80 marks. So these four chapters are important, whatever may be the criteria. And then one more is governance and technical support. We are not worried about the institute management or the principals or HODs, they will finalize what to be written in this chapter. So we should get the information from the institute authorities regarding governance, institutional support and financial resources, right? And so the first one, program level criteria, vision statement, mission and statements of the department and institute should be written properly. Then state the program educational objectives, you need to state 3 to 5. Then indicate where the vision and mission of and PEOs are published. So they should be published in web page, charts, notice boards and all, are in pamphlets or in brochure. So we should have orientation program during the starting of the semester. We should have orientation program where parents will come, students will come, right? That time we should have the habit of giving them the brochure where that POs are given, POs are written, vision is written, vision mission is written, POs are written, right? We should have the habit of that orientation day. Normally in reputed universities they do, in reputed institutes they do, they go for orientation program on the first day where students will assemble for getting the minimum information. There we should have brochure. We should supply the brochure to stakeholders. So then through email or like through industry employers, through email we can say. Then state the process of for defining the vision and mission of the department. So what process you have been involved? So the faculty may take care of their, faculty may worry about, may be worried about their own vision, mission and POs. Faculty of that particular concerned program must be worried about that. They will finalize, right? And then they should put it in the faculty meeting and get it approved, then put it in the institute faculty meeting or some other higher authority. Once it is approved, then we can get the approval of the stakeholder. right? We should get the approval of stakeholders in the month of May or June during the meeting, right? Approval of getting the approval of stakeholders is a must, and then those are all under supporting document, but this process should be described here. The process should be described here. Then establish the consistency of PEOs with mission statement. So M1, M2, M3, so on MN, so PEO1, PEO2 up to PEON. So relationship between PEOs and M1, right? You should give the number also, low level mapping, moderate level mapping and substantiate level mapping, okay? Tier 1 and Tier 2, they have the major difference is the SFR, that means the faculty scenario, SFR ratios, and then weightage to faculty contribution, right? Minimum criteria difference is there. In the pre-qualifier, you might have seen. For Tier 2, I think it is 50%, for Tier 1, it is 60%. So minimum criteria difference is there, and professors 2 should be there in Tier 1, and 1 is sufficient in Tier 2, like that. So minimum criteria difference is there. Anyway, we are discussing Tier 1, so we will go ahead. I hope we have got the answer. Then program curriculum, state the processes for designing the program curriculum. This is Tier 1, so obviously we have our own procedure of designing the curriculum. How frequently the curriculum development committee meets, and then how many years we will take care of the curriculum revision and all. So once it is designed, means how many years we are putting into role. So what kind of meetings we have, that description we should. And is it in accordance with the AACT regulations or not, that we should write here. Right? AACT, they have regulations, so basic sciences we should have this much weightage, advanced this program. Level electives, this much weightage and all. So they have given some guidelines. Accordingly, we have done it or not, we should discuss here. Then structure of the curriculum, LTP. So this is not there in earlier SAS. So structure of the curriculum we should give, but even in other SAS, UG, Tier 2 also, we should give the structure like this. So here they have mentioned, in the earlier SAS, they have not mentioned. Curriculum we should provide, the structure should be given along with SAR, like this only, for everybody. This is for everybody, but they have not mentioned in earlier SAS, but it should be given for everybody. State the components of curriculum. Yeah. So this you can use for other criteria people also, other Tier 2 also, or diploma people also. You can use this for your SAR also, even though it is not given. So it will be better for them to understand. So basic sciences, engineering sciences, how much is required, and total number of contact hours and total number of credits. The curriculum adopted or curriculum that is being designed should be as per the AACT norms. Right? Even recently also they have supplied us the document AACT, as per the AACT norms, what should be the syllabus for UG programs, what should be the syllabus criteria for PG programs. We have PG program, so we are looking into, and we are trying to implement the same in our institute. Same must be the case with you, right? No justification table is required for mission and PEO mapping, please. Only asked things you please do, right? Mission and PEO justification, wherever justification is required, that should be given orally. In SAR, you need not give the justification, sir, please. Even individual CEOs also, you can keep the calculation and keep with you, but overall CEO attainment only you can give, right? So, I hope everybody is consolidating their knowledge about accreditation and other institute-related processes, teaching-learning processes, in fact. So then, state the process used to identify the extent of compliance of curriculum for attaining the program outcomes and program specific outcomes. They are saying how it is complied with the curriculum, complied with respect to the POs and PSOs. So POs are already given, PSOs you have made, you have identified. So how curriculum is designed? So it is simple. Both are in relation with each other. So minimum curriculum, what are supposed to be there? These are indirectly there in POs. Basic knowledge, engineering knowledge, advanced knowledge, modern tools, all these are related terms. Only they are confusing us, right? So these are all related terms. Curriculum is indirectly or directly related to POs. Based on curriculum only, they have designed the POs. Right? So they must be in relation with each other. So that we should discuss here. Then teaching learning process. Important, that is 70 marks. Describe the processes followed to improve the quality of teaching learning. So we should give the academic calendar here. Apart from academic calendar, what are the additional things we are doing with respect to project works, labs, and other things? So mainly it is project works, collaborative learning, and then project laboratory experience, other activities what we are doing, and scope for encouraging the bright student and assisting the weak students. All this we should give mention separately apart from the academic calendar. The implement details and impact analysis also, it needs to be documented. So implementation details. Normally, every institute follow these processes. So we should write those processes in proper fashion, proper order, and in one or two paragraphs or three, four paragraphs. Then quality of end semester examination, internal semester question papers and all. So how we are setting the question papers and how we are setting the internal papers and how, what kind of assignments are given, how we are evaluating that process. Evaluation process, question paper setting. Examination people will tell you that. Then quality of student projects. We have different kinds of projects. We need to give how projects are allotted. That means depending on the faculty competency, we allot projects, right? So we identify what are the faculty competencies we have in our program, and then what kind of projects we are allotting, how many projects we are allotting to each faculty, how many students we are allotting to each faculty. So like that, we should discuss here, and then quality. So there itself we can indirectly we are mentioning the quality aspect. If you are providing competency aspect and also reviews, two reviews we are doing and we are grading them based on our reviews, that itself is, and we are ensuring that the quality is improved, right? Quality is good or like. So that's what here the hints are given as already. So product identification, allotment, continuous monitoring, that itself is indirectly related to the improvement of quality or maintenance of quality. Then initiatives related to industry interaction. So this is also good. This must be written properly, and also this four section. So then initiatives related to industry interaction. So from now onwards, at least out of 60 students we have, 2 to 3 projects are like can be industry related. Two to three can be application related, 2 to 3 can be research oriented. So clearly it is given, application, product development, research, review. So somebody say, how it is possible? Research is possible with BTech student. Yet it is possible. It is possible. Not in the first instance itself, you will get a publication. So first they will try to do something, they may fail or like, they will try to improve it. Next year, we will do similar topic. So further advancement will be there. After 2-3 iterations, some product development may be there. So this is possible. Even I have got student publications from M.Tech and B.Tech. So that is possible. SFR details already we have discussed, sir, 2-3 times, 4-5 times. So please, it is there in the document. Then initiatives related to industry internship summer training. Industries initiatives related to industry internship summer training. So mention the initiatives, implementation details, and the impact analysis. What are the initiatives we have with respect to the industry internship and summer training? whether it is there in the syllabus or not, no problem. You must go for industry internship. The students must go for industry training at the end of second year or third year. So we need to collect those reports and let them present also. You can grade them also. Those, based on those projects, can be decided. So those ultimately will become industry oriented projects or industry linked projects, right? So possibility is there. Only thing, we do not collect them and we neglect that, right? So that we can do. So if you see the second criteria, you can score maximum about 80 to 90 or like, right? Suppose industry interaction is there, we will lose marks. Then course outcomes, program outcomes. So for somebody is asking about 202, this is second semester or second year, second course, depending on the university and depending on the program. Second, first semester, second semester, or first year, first course, second year, second course, third year, third course, fourth year, like that, year-wise course. So that idea, that numbering, we are not read about. So we will follow our institute numbering or our university numbering, okay? COs should be written, and then C202 means for a particular course, CO1, CO2, like that, CON, PO1, PO2, and PO2. So all are self-explanatory, and then cumulative one. Suppose English is there, I can correlate it with, sub, it is like PO8 and PO10, communication and ethics. And we will give the number 2, 2, or 1 and 2, so according to the faculty decision taken by the faculty who have been teaching that particular course. Low level, moderate level, and substantial. One is for low level, moderate, and then high. So by now you should be clear about that, right? Statement in C, that is CO1. CO1 statement here. CO1 statement here, CO2 statement here. So minimum SFR is not given, not asked for. Minimum SFR is similar to that only, right? It is minimum SFR guidelines are not given with respect to basic science and humanities, right? It is put together, we will see SFR. So attainment of course outcome, by now you should be clear about attainments. So still doubts are there in CO attainment. Still doubts are there in CO attainment for internal examination, term end examination. We should get the marks and calculate our CO attainment. You see, now individual CO attainment is not discussed here. Right? Individual CO attainment is not discussed here. Anywhere it is not mentioned. It is the attainment of course outcomes of all courses only. Individual attainments, it is not discussed here. In recent diploma course, diploma sir, they have discussed in examples, but heading is again same. Attainment of course outcomes. Individual COs you can calculate and keep it with the course file. Here you can give this in course outcome cumulative CO attainment. Cumulative CO attainment. So CO attainment already you know that. So CO attainment is based on internal mass. So 80% that is internal as well as external as well as internal. This is external examination based on external examination. Based on internal examination. So according to the weightage, so suppose we have 80% in our university, 80% into 1 to 3 plus 20% into 1 to 3. Out of that level, we should discuss, we should get the number. Right? So accordingly, you can get 80% into 2, that is 1.6 plus 80%, 20% into 2, that is about 0.4. This is around 2. Based on internal mass, external mass. What is the criteria for internal mass? Suppose level 1 is 60% of the students crossing the 60% of the mark. Level 2, 70% of the students crossing 60% of the mark. Level 3, 80% of the students crossing 60% mark. So that 60 you can change it to 40, no problem. That should be same throughout. Same way, external examination. 60% of the students crossing the board average, that is level 1. 70% of the students crossing the board average, it is level 2. Level 3 is 80% of the students crossing the board average. Right? So suppose assuming it is 2, we have got 1.6. Assuming it is 2 here, we got 1. So like this, we can give the CO attainment for all the courses. CO attainment for all the courses. Like for the first course, 101, 102, 103, like that for first. For all the courses from first year to last year, we can give CO attainment in a given year. Right? Individual CVs you can calculate and keep if you want, right? Rubrics you can use if you want, but anywhere it is mentioned in there is term rubrics, somebody is saying, is rubrics somewhere used, somewhere the term is there somewhere in SAR? No, right? So if you want, you can use it for your better presentation. Somebody is asking for an autonomous institute also, it is like university. Suppose thermodynamics is there, it is not class average. Thermodynamics is there, mechanical person also may be writing, some chemical person also may be writing, some electrical they may also be writing that thermodynamics course. So it is university means all those program, that means all those averages you need to consider. There is no university attainment. There is no university attainment. There is a case that only one set of people have taken in the overall whole university or in the entire institute if it is affair. So that is possible. So then only class average. It is very rarely for PG courses, only for PG courses. Advanced topics, only one section of people taking that course. Then there is no university attainment. Somebody is asking about university attainment, we do not have, right? Right? Then there is something like PO attainment. PO attainment also, again I am repeating, I hope everybody is getting bored. PO attainment is based on direct and indirect. Direct in the sense through examination. Suppose I calculate PO1. PO1 may be related to 4 or 5 courses. Individual courses, individual attainment by that many courses. It will be average. That is direct. Direct assessment we will have, indirect assessment we will have. And weightages can be like PO attainment 80%, 80% into direct assessment 1 to 3 plus 20% into 1 to 3 indirect assessment. Indirect assessment means survey 1 to 3. Direct assessment is through CO attainment based on the number of courses. We will have one attainment with respect to PO1. Indirect attainment through surveys. From surveys of stakeholders, employee, faculty, students, alumni, industry or employer, and then parents, we will have indirect attainment, right? Through indirect surveys and all, we have attainment. So maybe 1 to 3 we will get. So accordingly 80% and 20%. It is clearly mentioned here. In case of PO attainment, it is given as 80% into direct attainment plus 20% into indirect attainment. Put together, you will get around 2.1 or 1.1 like that. So next year when you go for running the same program, you should set the targets. Like don't jump to 2.15, you just go, you set say 2.12. Right? So you must be clear by now. You must be clear by now this cycle. June to December, first before semester, before the year, starting of the year, we have faculty meeting, allotment of courses, setting of targets. For programs also, we will set the targets, year-wise targets. So then, classes, class test one, after that we have class committee meeting, form class committees, or you can say quality circle committees. Then class test two, class committee meeting. Then faculty meeting before the term and exam, then term and examination. What faculty meeting will do, any remedial classes are required, syllabus is complete or not here, how to prepare for term and examinations, how to plan for term and examinations, all those. So before term and examination also, we should have faculty meeting. Whether any further remedial classes are required or any problem with the completion of the syllabus, like that. So here faculty meeting, here faculty meeting, and after the examination also faculty meeting. Why this faculty meeting? In this meeting we will see what see the output of the attainment, output of the attainment, CO attainment or grading, any moderation is required and all we will do. That is again faculty meeting. So after then we will plan, or again we will have faculty meetings to set the targets, CO targets or whatever, or allocation of courses and all. The same scenario will be followed here. So this is June or July to December, again December to May or like that. Once this is over, you will have stakeholders meeting, or here you will have faculty meeting to conclude whether everything is okay or anything wrong. Then stakeholders meeting, parents, students, then industry or alumni, industry or employer, then alumni meeting. Then our meetings like BOS, Academic Council and BOG and all. Any modification or in the process or any modification suggested in the teaching learning process, that should be implemented before the starting of the next semester, new year. That is teaching learning processes. I am clear about, like evaluation somewhere, evaluation methods of teaching, any problem is there. Need not be curriculum. So maybe once in 3 years we can do regarding curriculum also, any changes we can note and, right? Whether it is mini project or practical class, it is we take it as course only. Please, we take it as course only. And somebody is asking about individual CO attainment. Individual CO attainment, for them also we will use the maximum mark. Suppose CO 1, we have a question for 12 marks. So against this maximum mark, how many of 60% of scored means it is level 1. 70% that minimum average 8 marks or 6 marks, it is level 2. Level 3, 80% of the students crossing the marks or 6 marks, against the maximum mark. Individual CO attainment also we can have that level set, against the maximum mark. Right, clear? CBIT? CO1 is related to a question, one question is related to CO1, and we have maximum mark of 6, 12, and we will set some number, passing number is 8 or 6. Based on that, we will decide the levels. Is it necessary to have sponsored projects for each academic year? Where are you, sir? Anyway, mini project and major project should be treated as courses only, right? And sponsored projects, year-wise you should have 10 or 15, there is no criteria. It depends on the institute you are in, right? There is no minimum criteria, right? And have you got that individual attainment, individual CO attainment? That is why I have told you already. So just like that, don't give the questions. Don't give the questions in
class tests and all. Don't give the questions. Like suppose I say 20 marks class test is there, 20 marks class test is there, 12 marks related to CO1, 8 marks related to CO2. Like that we will decide. Don't jumble the questions. Yeah, that's why I am telling you, individual CO attainment may be different and the overall CO attainment only they are asking for. In SAR, our NBA committee is asking for overall CO attainment. Overall CO attainment only is required, not individual CO attainment. Individual CO attainment you can calculate and keep it with your course file. Right? Don't try to match them. Don't try to compare them. Here again we will have different levels set here. Again at the maximum mark. Right? Clear? Suppose CO1, 12 marks we have. So 8 marks, suppose you say pass mark, or 6 marks you take pass mark. So 60% of them crossing that, 60, 70 crossing that, 80 crossing that. So you will set levels here again for individual COs. Right? So don't try to combine again with CO attainment. Similar levels you will set according to the maximum mark. Clear? There is no percentage of industry sponsored projects. Yes, very good. You have got the clear idea, sir. The individual CO attainments are not mandatory to show the NBA committee. In SAR, you need not have individual CO attainments shown, but you can calculate and keep it with you. Right? Anywhere it is given, only they are asking about course outcome, CO attainment based on courses. Individual CO attainment, anywhere they have asked for. Right, here you see, record the attainment of CO course outcomes of all courses, right? So, but anyway, individual outcomes, if you have understood the concept, individual course outcomes also can be calculated and keep it in course file. Even few years back, long back also, I was involved in individual course outcome attainment. But that doesn't lead to a specific direction or like. So we'll calculate and keep it. Is it necessary to that HOD should be the program coordinator? Sir, you are not in an institute. HOD, attainment of PO outcome, program outcomes and program specific outcomes, the processes we have discussed long for many times. So basically first course, PO1, right, PO attainment. So only the attainment of COs is required, right? Final attainment. So those things we can give here. That you can club here and then have direct attainment and then surveys. Survey 1, survey 2, survey 3. So stakeholder surveys, indirect attainment. So put together we will have overall attainment. Right, put together we will have overall attainment. That formula also they have not given here in tier 1. So same formula you can hear. Somebody is asking about, is the internship essential factor? Yes, essential factor only. You please stick to the presentation. Internship is an essential factor only, sir. All the things are required. Some of them you may not have. So you will lose mass, don't worry about that. That's why. Sanctioned intake of the program N. So the fourth criteria is student performance. So third criteria, COs, POs. By now, there should not be any doubt with regard to COs and POs. So you must be the model for other colleges. As a faculty, you should be model for other faculty. Right, you should guide other faculty how to have course outcomes prepared, how to make course CO attainment, how to prepare PO attainment, how to have quality improvement in the institute, right?
how we should have continuous assessment. These kind of continuous assessment scenarios nowhere followed, right? If you follow that, you will be the best institute among the people who are there, right? So this is not being followed everywhere. So you must do it, right? Then intake details, and then people passing, successfully graduating without backlog year wise. Clearly, you might have understood clearly. So for the present assessment year, we cannot have the first year result, right? So that's why it is blank. So this is what assessment year calculation and data presentation. For the last year, we have first year calculation, first year details. So without backlog, how many of them have passed, right? So like this, we should have complete data for 3 years. So then this is with backlog, without backlog, and with backlog. It is against the admitted students only. Somebody in the morning ABS, somebody you are asking about against sanctioned intake or like, no, it is not against sanctioned intake. It is against the admissions. So 50 admitted, and all of them have successfully passed without backlog, then you will have only zero here in with backlog. ABS college, you have got clarity? Then, so for examples also are given here. So total in sanction and then any other. So examples are also given. So even number of students successfully passed with backlog and without backlog. So if you see clearly, suppose say 20, 30, 30, 40, 14, so 90 we have, and then 20 put together, it should be less than that of overall. Then enrollment ratio. Students enrolled against the sanction. Students enrolled against the sanction. Then if you have better enrollment, you will get more marks. So last 3 years criteria you should give. If it is more than 90, you will get maximum marks. Plus you will get a marks cut accordingly. Then success rate without backlogs in first any year. So that means for the pass out students, we should be able to judge the scenario. So success index is given for 3 years, full pass out batch, right? And then this is with backlog, full pass out batch students. Clearly it is given, if 100% clear without any backlog, then also total marks scored will be 20. So that means put together we will have zero. So the marks will be clubbed there, don't worry about. Morning somebody was asking this, right? It is marks will be combined that time. Then academic performance of the year in second year. So year wise CGPA against total number of students appearing in the examination. Then placement details, higher studies and entrepreneurship. So number of against number of students, how many we have. So this is SAR data, right? So supporting data, we should have appointment letter, we should have admission letters, right? We should have, suppose somebody, you are saying somebody has opted for entrepreneurship or life, right? Self-employed if he has preferred. So that also we should have details. Which organization, which enterprise, or somebody is running their family business, we are not worried about that. We get the letter where they are positioned, right? So for us, he is employed only. We should get the record, right? So that is why the safe point they have mentioned here, placed in companies or government sector. Then higher. So put together, we should have around 50%, 60%. So we should be happy about that. All right. Then number of students turned entrepreneur in engineering or technology. Number of students turned entrepreneurs, so self-employment. So like this, we should have the data for last 3 years. So then provide placement data. So they are asking for appointment letters and also supporting document. We should have appointment letters in a file or batch wise. Okay? It is possible. So then professional activities, professional societies, chapters, organizing engineering events. We should have professional society membership in professional societies and an institute also, and individuals also we should have, and we should be organizing events. If not, we should send our students to nearby institute where they are organized. So suppose you do not have professional membership and you will lose only this 5 marks, right? Then publications of technical magazines, newsletters and all. So you should have one magazine or like institute magazine. Suppose you have problems and you do not have, that means you will lose only 5 marks. So later on you can improve. Later on when you apply for next time, you should have all the deficiencies rectified, right? So participation, all the documents were given earlier. Again, somebody is asking for documents. All the documents were given except the PPT. All the documents were given. Participation in inter-institute events by students of the program. So, inter-institute. So, this has 10 marks. So, we should take it seriously. So, if you are not organizing any events, or even then, you should send students to reputed institutes for participating in design competitions, coding competitions. Extracurricular activities is last. Suppose you say IIT are like, IITs or NITs are reputed universities or engineering colleges. They are conducting year-wise technical programs, year-wise. Year-wise they have one technical event. So there you can send your students for paper presentation or model competition or design competition, or coding competition, programming competition, possible, right? So those details you will discuss here. So if you have better, so you will have 20% of 20 marks. So this is with regard to students activity. So now the main thing is faculty. Faculty, we have maximum marks 200 marks. So faculty qualification and SFR. So SFR is, again I am telling you, it is number of students in the department overall by total number of faculty, excluding first year, right? That's why UG1, only 3 years it is given. So SPIF, or as per the norms you have submitted to AACT. So same values you can give here. Individual numbers you need not give. You can give only these last two lines you can give. Total number of students in the department, total number of faculty in the department, SPIF. For the last 3 years, what is the ratio that you can give here? Accordingly, you will be asked, reduce your marks will be cut. Here also it is mentioned who are regular or like, so clearly, and also it is given clearly that the contractual faculty who have taught for 2 consecutive semesters in the corresponding academic year on full-time basis shall be considered for the purpose of SFR calculation. So you must be happy about that. So SFR, you must be meeting the requirement. Even in AACT norms also, even in AACT approval also, you might have met all these, then only you should have got approval. Otherwise, you should not have got AACT approval. And also, as per the regulations of AACT, provide information of regular faculty, contractual faculty. So then faculty cadre proportion, so for faculty with PhD, so 1:2:6 is a must. Already in the example it is clearly given. Suppose intake is 60, total number of students is for 3 years it is 180. So required faculty excluding first year, this is BTech, so we are excluding that first year academics is different, so we are excluding that first year. So then required faculty is 9, 1, 2, 6. So again this is required. Against this, how many are available? So accordingly, marks will be given. This is faculty cadre proportion. If you have, as per the requirement, that is 1:2:6, you get 20 marks. Got it? Everybody is asking about SFR. I hope by now you have got and qualification, people are asking for qualifications and all. So suppose 60 batch is there, total 180, so 9 faculty, that is 1 professor, 2 associate professor and 6 assistant professor. So if you have all the 9, maximum mark, right? So if you do not have, accordingly marks will be cut. Maximum mark is limited to, it is limited to 20. Then faculty qualification, number of faculty with PhD, number of faculty with M.Tech. So according to the PhD and M.Tech, we have the formula. So for the last 3 years, we should get the faculty qualification index. Then faculty retention. Normally, all of you may be scoring better. So that is, if it is more than 90% retention is there, 90%. Normally, we should have, normally we do not have faculty getting removed or like, right? So the last 3 years, what is the criteria? Otherwise, we will lose certain marks, right? So then faculty competency in correlation with the program specific criteria. So here it is clearly mentioned, suppose civil is there, the faculty who is teaching civil must be related to that. Faculty competency must be there. Right? Faculty program specific civil you say, civil related criteria you will. Cadre ratio for PG programs, as per the PG formula, you please follow, sir. Here it is BTech formula we have used. So similar, PG program, in PG, sir, it might have been given, sir. Please, formula might have been given there. Then innovations by the faculty. So innovations by the faculty in teaching learning process. So here, once for all, I must tell you, somebody told you all these are already in use, how they can be innovative. It is not that, sir. It is not that. So here it is clearly mentioned, suppose you are using ICT, that is also innovation only. ICT was derived some a few years back, so still it is also innovative only. So PPTs, 30 years or 40 years are over, but still there. So then change in instructional delivery. So with respect to instructional delivery change, right? Then instructional methods, any other. Then assessment, if you are making any assessment, innovative method in assessment, getting the feedback or changing the regulations and all. Then evaluation and inclusive classrooms. That lead to effective and efficient and engaging the instruction. So improvement in any aspect. Don't assume that they are already done. Suppose thermodynamics, you say, not thermodynamics, it is not taught through videos and PPTs. It is through practice and blackboard. Suppose somebody is using PPT, it can be innovative only. Or suppose somebody is bringing lab components to thermodynamics class and explaining, that is innovative. Innovative is that. Even every time I fill some form or like, we have that option of innovative method. What are the innovative methods you are using? I say I do not give take home assignments. I adopt classroom assignments, so that is a class assignment. So that is innovative method. Even in PowerPoint, explaining PowerPoint layout also, I use Blackboard. Okay. So if I use PPT, that will be innovation only. If I use videos, then still it is better. But I will never use all that. Right? Anyway, so depending on the course, you can show innovative ideas, what are being adopted. And innovation in evaluation. Already I have shown you the assessment. This is assessment. This assessment method also may be innovative. Have you been following this? Maybe some you are following, all completely not following. So this is also an innovative method of assessment, continuous assessment where we have. Okay? Then instructional methods, any change in instructional methods, ICT mode or videos, NPTEL, seminar, webinar, all those. The work must be made available on institute website. What kind of innovations you are making so that others will also follow? That's what their intention, right? So, suppose you say something innovative, so peer reviews should will comment, right? The work must be reproducible. So innovation also is possible everywhere, sir, I must tell you. So faculty as participants in faculty development or training activities, so this kind of training programs you can attend. So faculty should be attending this. It is not even me also, I try to attend in the conferences of reputes, so that I am present there. So everywhere we should, that is how you can level up. Suppose you say you are a big good scientist and you are a good researcher, so that should you have to apply that, right? So in practice also you should adopt that. So even recently also I have gone to IIT Bombay and presented one of my papers, and then again I there also I had questions asked. So people have some other reputed professors, they have asked questions. Then that is how you can improve day by day or like. And even I have attended one international conference, Asian workshop or like in Trivandrum. So you can improve like that only, right? You need to face audience. You need to face, if you are a good researcher, you should keep on presenting papers in reputed conferences or like, right? And training, you should attend at least one or two per year or like, so this will be directly or indirectly helping you, right? And it will improve your curriculum. Even in my resume also, I can tell you that at least 10 to 15 training programs I have attended as a faculty also. So it is required. And then around 20 to 25 conferences, international and national conferences, I have attended. Still I continue to do that. As a researcher and as an academician, we are expected to do these kind of activities, right? And faculty, so that's why. So if you want to score maximum mark, you need to keep on attending. So we are at NITTR Kolkata. You are welcome to NITTR Kolkata. And anytime you want any program at your end, then also we can come and give the training there if it is required. So we have four programs: civil, mechanical, electrical and computer science. Also we have education department, various kinds of training programs take place. So if you are interested, you can write to us. So for government institutes it is free, for private institutes we charge some, right? So otherwise some nearby reputed organizations, nearby reputed IITs or NITs, you can send your faculty for training program. That is how you can know what is happening there, or they also come to know you are there, you are an academician, you are expert in this area or like. So there may be a possibility that you can be guest lecturer there, you can be giving guest lectures there or invited talks there, or they may be called for taking invited lectures or like. So this is how you can have institute to institute interaction, right? So don't expect that all the time you are in the receiving end or like. So you may attend training sessions or training programs, that time they come to know, yes, these are the abilities you have. So they may call for certain lectures or invited talks and all. So, and you can call them if it is required for students and all. So both ways it is possible. So then R&D, so academic research. So some people were saying, so we do not have academic research and all, means in the sense we will lose that many publications are not there, means that many marks we will lose. So try to adopt publication aspect also, that is SCA, Scopus Index and Science Citation Index, refereed journals only. Normally journals, just like don't go for journals. So there are only two types as far as my knowledge is concerned, Science SCI and Scopus Index. And suppose some other, if you are of some other branch or some other department, you may be certain criteria. So that you may please adopt. And other areas like IEEE, then ASME, SAE, FMFP, different organizations, different societies, they conduct conferences or they have publications. That is a different. And then conferences, what kind of conferences you need to attend? Reputed organizations, if they conduct, then only. Don't go just like that. Somebody say international conference on so and so is being conducted. Don't go just like that. So NIR ranking is there. We can follow, we can check whether it is reputed institute or not. Suppose we are keeping some conference paper in our biodata or resume, means somebody must be appreciating that, right? So just like that, some international conference in some college it is being conducted and you have attended, so appreciation is not there, or they are not recognizing, that means it is not good for us, right? So reputed institutes like IITs or NITs or reputed state level or international universities, that universities, or other kind means certification kind. So different aspect, like for computer science people, they have different scenario. For mechanical, different kinds of people. So reputed societies, reputed organizations, you know already, to try to publish them in SCA or Scopus Index or in related. So, right? Then sponsored research, BST, AACTE, and DRDO, HAL, good number of organizations, so you can apply for. If not individual, you can apply together, so that means 2 to 3 people combined together, they can go for. Then you are not involved in any of these, at least you can try for product development, research laboratories, instructional materials. So then consultancy, engine testing or material testing and all, you can develop some money, produce some money. Then faculty performance appraisal. Faculty performance appraisal system must be in place. What is the procedure you have? We are adopting that, you should discuss here. Faculty performance appraisal form should have the type of load you are dealing with, the type of programs you are attending, training programs you are attending, the publications you have, the kind of activities you have done. That means administrative roles or any other. So like this, we have different indices. So you can prepare your own self-appraisal form, faculty appraisal form, get it filled at the end of every year. So then visiting and adjunct faculty, so it is clearly given. So based on 50 hours or like, we'll get maximum marks. So every time I'm telling you, you should have industry interaction and also institute interaction. You go to some training program or you call somebody, they will come to know you, what about your abilities and all. So you may be the expert there, right? So person is there like that, they should understand, right? So you need to go there or they need to come. So either of them should happen. Then only the mutually you will be able to develop. They will also be benefited from your expertise, and you will also be benefited from their expertise, right? So faculty contribution is about 200 marks. So be thorough with that. Then criteria, facilities and technical support, adequate and well-equipped laboratories. So details of the laboratories we should give, name of the important equipment, adequate and well equipped, that means according to the norms we have or not, please, we can discuss here. Suppose technical staff is not there, you can mention the corresponding faculty who is conducting the classes, right? So you can say with interest faculty is taking care of the class. Then lab maintenance and overall ambience, already I have told you. Maintenance sheet, logbooks you can prepare, logbooks you can maintain, maintenance sheets also you can maintain, right? Then safety measures in laboratories. Suppose thermal lab or any related, means engines or light are there, means you should have safety extinguisher, fire hazardous equipment. If anything is fire hazardous, you should have the fire extinguishers and all, definitely. So safety measures must be there, the thermal lamp, and nearby we should have safety extinguisher and all. So what are the safety measures taken in each lab, we should discuss here. This is tier 1, so separately they are asking for safety measures. Then project laboratory, important, 20 marks. So whatever the facilities you have beyond the syllabus and beyond the curriculum, you can show under self-learning or under project laboratory. You can have separate space for them. Suppose somebody is doing research on something, or somebody is doing for his PhD, whatever the setup he has designed, that also can be put under project laboratory. All should be in a separate space, not placed distinct separately or like in the same place or like. So even facilities and technical support also, we have about 80 marks. Right? Then continuous improvement. So we have already continuous improvement, we have already mentioned in the earlier lectures. We have discussed in length target how to set and attainment level, against attainment level, and what kind of actions taken should be there. So all those things we have discussed in three times we have discussed. I hope you have understood by now, that is continuous improvement. Then academic audit. So every time I am telling you this, academic audit is a must. Professor of one department should visit the, should check the teaching learning processes of other department, and he should report it to the HOD, so that there must be some actions taken. Right? Improvement in placement, higher studies and entrepreneurship. So already I have told you, so that you can use this XY plots. Improvement in placement, improvement in number of people opting for higher education, improvement in number of people going for GRE or TOEFL or GRE scores you can put. So anything is possible, right? Then improvement in the quality of students admitted to the program, that means cutoff mark. Improvement in cutoff rank, and then improvement in MPC percentage, CPM percentage, mass physics percentage, right? So that also one criteria. Improvement in average CGPA also, improvement in average CGPA, improvement in CPM percentage, or improvement in number of trainings by the faculty, improvement in number of publications. So all those things you can plot in XY, right? Then first year academics separately, same what we have discussed in fourth unit. Separately, we need to give first year faculty ratio, then first year qualification details, then first year performance, academic performance, average CGPA, then assessment, CO assessment and PO assessment, same. So here we will not have indirect assessment, here we will have only direct assessment pertaining to first year courses. And targets also, we can have separate targets for first year. Then student support system, mentoring system. So counseling aspect you should adopt. So every faculty must be assigned some 30 students are he will be the counselor. As long as they are on the campus, he will be the counselor or mentor. So that system you should discuss here. Then feedback analysis for reward or corrective action steps. Feedback. Any you might have taken that any corrective actions taken. So reward actions. So normally rewarding measures are not there in institute. Best teacher award or anything, you are not there, right? So don't worry about that. At least negativity is not there, means that is good for us, right? Corrective actions taken, so that may be there. And also facilities, feedback on facilities. So in POs they might have given feedback that stakeholders might have given feedback on facilities, so that you can work on.
Self-learning, so webinars, seminars, MOOCs, all those things will be under self-learning. Whatever that is there beyond the syllabus, that you can put under self-learning. Alright, then career guidance, training and placement. So already we have discussed in length couple of times. So those details we should give, what kind of skill development you are doing and what kind of industry linkage we have, all those things we can discuss here. Then entrepreneurship self. So the institution may describe, so the details of entrepreneurship self can be given here.
First year performance only for 3 years we should give. First year for this year, last year first year, previous year first year. So year wise, first 3 year wise. Then co-curricular and extracurricular activities. So NCC, NSS like designing competitions, all the designing activity. People are asking for publications, sir. Publication, your institute name should be there in that paper. Then only you can consider it as your publication. Whether it is co-author or 10th author, no problem. Three days FDP, 3 months or 2 months it is given, and 5 days FDP, it is given. More than 5 days, it is 5 marks. It is 5 days workshop, 5 days FTP, 3 marks it is given. What is the meaning of association with the institution format? Also designation already mentioned. I think I didn't get it, please. Regarding feedback form on it. We will give the feedback form, sir. We'll give the feedback form. Our academic section will be mailing you the required feedback form for this course. You can give the feedback. Tomorrow, today itself, we will try to mail you, get it printed and Xerox. So, Google Forms are like, whether it is authenticating or not, I don't know, sir, but you should get the feedback, whatever may be the method, whether it is authenticated or that, I don't know. Feedback, physical feedback, sir, just or in through email. With sign or something. Physical feedback. Electronic feedback? No. Physical feedback. Sign and, or if not sign, at least with ink, they should write fill. For the program applied only. First year academics means first year academics related to the program, not the entire first year. Right? Normally first year will be same for all, right? So the same we should proceed. Same we should present. Then organization, last one, 10th one, 120 marks. So state the vision and mission statements. Then availability of the institutional strategic plan and its effective implementation and monitoring. So institute strategic plan should be there for next 3 years, what you want to be. So that institutional strategic plan, somebody was asking this yesterday. So institutional strategic plan in the sense, what can in next 3 years or next 5 years, what you want to become. Like what kind of setups you want, what kind of faculty strength you want, what kind of programs you want, any additional things you want. Right? That is institutional strategic plan. Departments will have strategic plan, put together institute strategic plan is there. Right? Even in our organization also, our director asks every time about our departmental strategic plan for next 5 years. So mechanical engineering strategic plan, computer science as engineering strategic plan for next 5 years, all put together, civil engineering. So like this, all department strategic plans for 5 years put together, we will have institute strategic plan for next 5 years or like that. That is strategic plan. Even in our institute also, our director has asked recently, what about our strategic plan or like in mechanical engineering? We have planned something like this many projects, this many labs we will develop, this kind of labs we will develop, or this kind of faculty we want, or this kind of programs we want to float. So strategic plan is that. So same way, other departments people also will give civil, mechanical, civil, computer science and all. So the head of the institute or the director will consolidate it all. So that is institute strategic plan for next 5 years or next 3 years. Every institute does it, right? They should have proper plan with them, otherwise, right? So it is required, and it's implementation and monitoring. Assessment we are doing, so it is towards institute strategic plan only, right? Assessment we are doing, so that is towards like faculty appraisal form we are getting filled, so total number of publications we are getting, total number of projects they are doing, that we are getting. So all put together will lead to monitoring, implementation and monitoring after.
Okay.
Any other, then governing body, so administrative setup, function of various bodies, service rules and procedures, so entire structure, roles and responsibilities you should give, then rules and service rules, recruitment procedures, promotional policies, discipline procedures, all those things, right? Structure you should give, flowchart you should give. You should give the roles and responsibilities of all, right? Organizational structure from the higher authority, director, and under director we have different sections. Under different sections we have different HODs, and up to the lab technician, the full flowchart must be clear to you. We have to give the roles and responsibilities of all of them in SAR. Recruitment principles, disciplinary procedures taken, all you should mention there. All right? Course exit form feedback is nothing but course-wise feedback form. Course-wise feedback form is necessary. Without that, we should not be running courses. Decentralization in working and grievance redressal mechanism. This must be in place everywhere, grievance redressal mechanism and decentralization in working. That means, suppose faculty has a problem, whom you should meet? That means the HOD. That HOD has a problem means you will meet the director or principal of the institute. So, suppose lab technician has the problem, so he will meet the lab in charge or faculty. So like this, the entire structure, entire decentralization in working must be in place. That you should discuss here. Normally institute do not follow this. Yes, they should follow this. But in every institute, just like that, they go and tell something to the director or principal. Is it there? Yes, it is there everywhere. So decentralization in working, in the sense, suppose we have problem means we should approach the nearest head. That means our reporting authority, not directly. We should not go to director or principal. HOD or the faculty has any problem means they will report to HOD. If problem is not solved, so then how to proceed further? So directly we cannot go to the principal or like, but institutes people are following this. Then lab technician. So you should proceed, you should inform, you should discuss the matter with the lab in charge and wait for the solution and reply. Then only HOD. Otherwise, then only director. Just directly going to that is hierarchical maintenance. It must be there in place. That is what decentralization in working. And grievance redressal mechanism. So centralized grievance redressal mechanism may be there. In admin section, administrative section, they may be having that redressal mechanism. So anti-ragging committee and harassment committee. Then delegation of financial powers, who are given the authority of checking, authority of signing the checks, allocation of funds and all, we should discuss here.
All these are like questions, and we should answer them in paragraphs or points, bullet points, right? Transparency and availability of correct ambiguous information in public domain. Transparency and availability of that and correct information in public domain. Whether we are able to do it or not, we should. Then budget allocation. There are two types of budget allocation. Already I have told you, institute level budget and program level budget. Institute level budget details. From now onwards, at least whatever the fund you have, you should segregate it into recurring and non-recurring. And even they are asking for the amount we are spending for student, each student. Okay? Then non-recurring, what are recurring aspects? Maybe like library, laboratory equipment, and then travel and all. So recurring and non-recurring, we should segregate and give it in proper heading. Institute level, and we should be able to discuss the adequacy, utilization, and availability, right? And then same way, program level budget we have. And budgeted expenses in the sense, how much you have planned. Actual expenses are different. Normally, institutes do not have this pattern. You should adopt this, right? In our institute also, we are doing this. So at the starting of the academic year, we are asking the HODs to get the to give us the budgeted expenses. How, what kind of budget they are in need of. So allotment will be done according to the availability, and then all that is different from actual expenses, right? Then whether it is being properly utilized or not, adequacy is there or not, you should be able to discuss properly. These are 10 marks question, means we should discuss properly, fair. Every time you should understand that we should discuss properly, then only you will get maximum mark. Don't expect that they will correct like this, a question paper, answer script are like, no. They will see overall, right? They will not check individually 5 marks out of 10, they will give 5, they will not do like that. In overall they will give, so you must be happy about that. Then library and internet. So details should be given as per the requirement. Or quality of learning resources, details, internet detail. So the proper maintenance of library is required. Shelves should be proper. Issuing scenario should be proper. Then there should be a space for reading and all. Right? Different types of books should be there, and then different types of journals, both soft and hard. Try to be the member of NDL, National Digital Library, right, where you have so many sources available. So then internet, type of internet and all, Wi-Fi connectivity, that you know better than me. The last one is declaration, and then these are program outcomes for UG's Tier 1. Program outcomes, problem analysis, engineering knowledge, design and solutions, modern tool usage, engineering and society, ethics and community. So lifelong learning. So these are different program outcomes already we have been discussing. We have discussed earlier also, we have been discussing this from the first day, right? So that is what Tier 1, UG Tier 1. So you might have understood whatever may be the program, all are similar. Same way you have diploma, same way you have PG, same way you have Tier 1, and same way you have Tier 2. So similar aspects are there. So only format is different. Only format is different, right? Somewhere weightage is also slightly different. I hope by now we have understood everything. You must be expert by now in NBA accreditation. You must guide others, right? Now, any questions are there, you please let me know, right? You please let me know if you have any questions. I will give the feedback form, sir. Please, CBIT, I will give the feedback form. I think we will mail it. All. Huh?
So they will circulate among themselves. Just you need to change the title and date. Same feedback form.
So we will circulate the feedback form for this course. Tomorrow we will have a recap and feedback form submission. The feedback form you can send it by post, right?
By mail or post?
By email.
Email.
So feedback form you can send it later, right? You can fill during the session, you can fill or you can send by email or by post or like. Feedback forms I will supply, right? I will supply the feedback forms for this course today. You can fill them, you can get it circulated among your faculty. Tomorrow morning you can get it filled or you can mail or you can send it by post. Right? Any other question I will take now. I have done too much, I have done more than required I feel, but anyway, any questions are there I will take now. Financial power delegation, that means authority to give checks, right? In our institute, example I am telling you, in our institute only director is given the authority of issuing checks. Suppose you apply for some lab maintenance or like some 1,000 rupees you want, so HOD or other faculty are not given the authority, only the directors is given the authority. That is what financial power. Library budget and utilization, it is not required here at this point. Additional facilities in labs, no, not required. So tomorrow morning we will discuss the files required or documents required, that is recap. Tomorrow morning I will discuss the documents required. Documents required means what kind of files we can have. Tomorrow we will discuss. Supporting documents and all, tomorrow we will discuss, sure. Yeah, tomorrow morning I will discuss the type of documents, types of files required and all, right? Tomorrow morning we will discuss more, and by 2 to 3 we will complete the session. By 3 we will complete the session, right? Any other doubt you please ask. Thank you. Let the academic year change. So this is very April, right? April end we are. So let the academic year change. Maybe in June, July you can apply for NBA accreditation. Somebody is asking about that. Compliance report as it is, as given in the format, right? No discussion is required, I think. Compliance as it is. Criteria-wise minimum marks are not there. Criteria-wise minimum marks are not there, right? And I will supply the feedback form today. It's by mail. You can get it circulated and you can send it by mail or you can send it by post to, right? Online feedback, you please don't prefer, sir. You just get the sign or like when they come for meetings and all. That time you take. online feedback is not so regulations you are asking for NBA, right? So let the year change. So then we will have fixed regulations. So that regulations you can follow. Four types of regulations means what do you mean that? What do you mean that? Four regulations you have means what do you mean? Online feedback will save paper. If you want to do everything online, save everything, right? Yeah. Please, I will discuss about the documents required, supporting files and all, supporting document. Somebody is asking for saving the paper. Please save the paper. Don't worry. Save everything. Slow learners, remedial classes, already I have told you on the first day. R14, R15. Anyway, you try to submit in June, July, that time, right? Recent regulations only you try to follow. Recent regulations only you try to follow, right? Can HOD be an NBA coordinator? Even principals are also can be an NBA coordinator. Principals or directors are also can be NBA coordinator. Please, anybody can be NBA coordinator. Directors are also can be NBA coordinator. Anybody else? Any question else?
Thank you all. So, thank you all. I have done my level best to convince you and regarding NBA accreditation and the necessity of that.
And also I have talked about so many things related to institute development, quality, teaching learning process, pedagogy, outcomes, everything. So I hope you can adopt, right? So tomorrow we will meet at 10:15, right? 10:15, 10:30.
We'll start the session by 10:30 tomorrow.
Meet at 10:15.
Thank you.